everybody, this is your host Nazmi Jannat representing to you an amazing show about the greatest magician AC Shikdar. And the name of our show is The Magician AC Shikdar and the Magic Bangla TV. Display of tricks of magic was rampant on streets, on countryside and on the marketplaces. And as far as I can remember, these magicians used to win our hearts by their amazing performances. But there is one among us who has taken the initiative to carry on such act, and his only mission and vision is to spread the art of magic worldwide. Thus, he visits many countries across the globe and has won trillions of hearts with his wonderful magic tricks. And he is none other than our favorite and beloved Shafiullah Shikdar. He has excelled in his career and a pride to Bangladesh. And this renowned magician also informs us about the ancient history of magic. According to AC Shikdar, magic is an art which was originated in ancient Bengal, from where it spread to the West. Many Western magicians perform magic tricks in guise of Bengali, which is in fact still now being continued at present. Explanation of the meaning of art is not limited in human life, because the first step of an art is one's spiritual and sensible satisfaction. Okay guys, so let's not wait any longer and get to the conversation with AC Shikdar. So Mr. Shikdar, tell us about how you feel to be one of the greatest magicians in history.
You see, I don't think, or I don't feel yet, that I am the greatest magician, but people acclaim, people say, I am the greatest. This is the people love me, so they...
Okay, tell us now, as we already know that you are a legend of Bangladesh, so what brought you to this profession? How did you become a magician?
It's a long story. When I was very young, almost 4 or 5 years, you know, in the village, the snake charmer, they go village to village, house to house. One of them came to our home, show some snake charming, the snakes dance up, and also they perform some magic. You see, they show me one small egg, bird egg. Suddenly, a bird appeared from his hand. But that's why I was astonished and I attracted to him.
So you got impressed by that magic.
Yes.
How did the egg become bird? Okay.
And after that, when I become slowly bigger and bigger, I introduced with the other magician. One of them, late, the great Shamoni. He was also a legend of Bangladesh at that his time. He teach me some magic. After that, I go to India, Thailand, China, anywhere, and I develop myself as a magician.
So, Mr. Shikdar, as I live in Bangladesh and I'm a Bangladeshi, since childhood I have been loving magic myself, but I do feel that the magicians in Bangladesh do not have that much effect in our public like the ones they have abroad. So, why do you think the magicians in Bangladesh are backseated?
I think I differ with your question. Any magician in the village or in the urban or city area, they have some impact. Everybody loves magic.
Yes, we do.
You know, and some sort of lacking of backing, that is called like technical support, and financial support. All of these the main backlog in our this art. In our country, we do not have enough funding or enough patronizer who support the magician. Our magician do themselves, they do any way they make some magic, they earn some money. But they don't have any experience in the abroad, or even in our country don't have any good teacher. That's why this is not any institutional background. We need institutional background support for this area. We are trying to establish an institution and like to teach the people the good message.
Okay, so basically it's the financial and the technical support that we are lacking in Bangladesh. Yes, yes. And if we have that, we'll also have the magicians. Yes. Like we have in abroad. Okay.
You know, you I think you don't forget, you know, one name, P.C. Sarkar. He was son of this Bengal.
Okay.
He was son of our country. And he is also a world famous magician.
So he's the pride of our country, definitely. Just like
pride of our country.
Is there already any organization running in Bangladesh, or you are planning to develop a new one?
More than one organization in our country.
Okay. Is it affiliated with the...
One of the Bangladesh Magician Council, that in Bangladesh Jadugar Parishad. It is affiliated with the International One Magician, FISAM, Federation of International Magicians. And also many Bangladeshi magicians are a member of International Brotherhood of Magicians.
Okay, so what position do you have there? What role are you playing?
At present, I am the president of the Bangladesh Magicians Council. Okay. As well as I'm Federation of Bangladesh Magicians, I am the president. And also the territorial vice president of International Brotherhood of Magicians.
Congratulations on that, and we are really lucky to have you.
Thank you.
What further plans do you have on this organization? How are you planning to develop it?
Our next plan to organize an international convention in our country to gather the more than 200 countries magicians in our country to introduce our magic to the world.
Well, that's awesome. Do you think it's one way to spread the magic all over the country?
This is the one way, but not the only way. Other than this, we have established one magic, full magic channel in our country, 24 hours magic channel, TV channel. It is online now.
All right. Well, as by the name, we can already guess the Magic Bangla TV, which is supposed to be on magic. Tell us something more about the channel.
This is almost now as online-based TV, IPTV. And in near future, we are trying to make it a satellite, full satellite TV. And it's our aim, main aim, to establish the magician and make popularity the magic to the people. And other this, we will also introduce our culture, art and culture, in different aspect of our country with this channel. You know, magic cannot go alone. Magic is a part of different art, like 18 art together makes magic kola. You know?
Yes.
Magic is a 18 different part of the art culture. We get together and make a magic. This way it is a very, very vast opportunity. With our channel, we can make it like drama, a mime show. Everywhere, we can put our magic. Magic, you can do, people can show the magic trick anyway, but it is not the nice looking. When you put the drama in this, the sequence in this, and make a very tremendous, tremendous impact in the stage, the people is applause and the astonished, what is going on? But if you show the only trick, nobody like the magic.
Yes.
All together, when you put in this magic, it will become art.
Combination of everything.
Yes,
it's a combination.
Yes.
Of
that's why we have many things to do in our channel.
Okay, we are looking forward to see everything you have in mind. Is your magic channel promoting the young ones too?
Yes, obviously. We are planning to promote our children to make them a future world famous magician. We are planning different way to establish the through our federation it's called workshop, and we have already established a magic college.
Okay, magic
so
college.
It is a very great opportunity to learn magic in the world class standard.
Okay, that's great. So, Mr. Magician,
yes.
We all know that you have visited a lot of countries and performed there. What do you think was their reaction, or how did they welcome you?
You see, first advantage, I am a magician from Bengal.
Yes.
So they imagine the Bengal magic and they like very much to welcome me. I will do something else other than them and a different way. So they very love very much in the traditional Bengal magic.
Okay, so you have performed everywhere, almost all over the world, as well as in Bangladesh, and you have performed in big shows. So what do you think when you perform at the same show in Bangladesh, do you get the same reaction?
I get the same reaction, but I don't do the same thing what I do in the Western part. I do here the Western magic in Western magic magician way. So our people like this very much.
Okay, so it's vice versa basically.
Yes. I know our country people, what they love, they love change.
Okay.
The people of Western people, they also like the change.
Give us a few examples of what you do in Western countries and what you do in...
When I do same magic, I do dressing and dialogue and everything, even apparatus, is the Indian way, the great Bengal way, the Western part. But when I do magic in Bangladesh, I do every get up from Western. So people make feel a changing. People like, you know, like when we saw the picture there, the movie, if we, sometimes we see the movie like our art film, our Bangla art film, and the commercial show. People make the difference. This is gorgeous, colorful, the commercial show. So I produce my commercial show in Bangladesh. But I produce my art film, art show to the Western.
Okay. So could you please tell us what is the first magic you practiced in your career, in your life? The first magic.
From beginning of my hour to conversation, I told you the egg. And bird.
Yes. So that was your first magic?
This was the first magic.
Okay, that's good. And I believe this is your favorite magic as well.
This is also favorite magic of many magicians of the world.
Okay. So, sir, we already know you are a legend of Bangladesh and almost throughout the world. So, you must have been struggling very hard to get to this position you have made. Tell us something about your struggle story.
You know, when I start our magic, this was not so easy in our country.
Yes.
It was, even there is no institution, to, not yet, yeah. But very hard to find a proper man who teach magic. This was also very hard. It was almost family business. Nobody disclosed his idea or profession to the other people. But we break this. My great teacher, he is also a doctor. He was an MBBS doctor. But he know the magic and he teach me to become a magician in this way. After that, many magicians, when I start almost 20 to 25 magicians in our country, but now it is almost 6,000 magicians.
6,000, that's a lot of number.
So, the time has changed. Now, very easy, if anybody desire to become a magician, just come to us to get admission to the college, to learn magic, and he can do the good magic.
By the grace of Almighty, you are a successful person now. But there are a lot of people who are struggling outside to achieve their goal. What suggestions do you have for them?
First of all, education first. Secondly, if he want to learn magic, he must start his early life because it needs lot of practice, lot of skillness. I think it is very good time for the school going children. They are part time extra curriculum activities. From that they slowly gradually learn the magic. After that, when he make a graduation complete, he will become
a complete magician.
And the opportunity, we can give them the proper teaching through our college, our personal guidance. We can make him.
Okay, I'll make an off-track question to you. We all have heard a lot of lot about you actually, and we also heard that you have vanished Eiffel Tower as well as some series. So how do you do that, and what is your experience about it?
Last 2 years before I have visited Paris, definitely we are have a walking outside the Eiffel Tower, visiting some of my followers say, "Oh magician, can you vanish this one?" Okay, I don't have anything, but I have only one stick that time in my hand. So wait, I will make this pair through this stick, Eiffel Tower in front of you right away.
You did not have anything with you, just
no,
one
just
stick.
I vanished like
Eiffel Tower.
That's a big time magic. I mean, how did you even do that? And I myself,
that's magic.
That is magic. And you do inspire us actually. And if I was a child, then even I would have started with the practice, definitely. And you have also vanished some cities like in Thailand.
Yeah, I have in China, I have done the walking through China Wall.
Okay.
I passed the China Wall. I
vanished it.
No, I go through the China Wall.
Oh, you passed through the China Wall.
I vanished there. Three buildings. I vanished one middle building in front of everybody.
And what was the reaction of people over there?
They. Astronauts everywhere. How did you do
the last question?
Okay, so did you ever have an experience like were the cops ever after you for performing such magics like vanishing the buildings or cities, whatever?
You see, when a magician go anywhere in the world, people don't know him. He is doing his way the thing, his magic. Somebody like cops and other people can get it. After that, when show any magic to him or make any magic with the cops or the people, they make
friendship.
Friendship.
That's the advantage of being a magician. Okay, so
it is very often when you go abroad, the people say, "Where are you going? How much dollar you have?" Common question. We don't carry any dollar. So we carry some white paper or something else. Okay, we make dollar and that's all.
Well, after knowing so much about your magic and its experiences, we definitely get very curious to see your magic. Like, personally, I am very curious to see your magic as well as the audiences, I think. So please show us some.
Okay, I will share one experience with you. As a musician, I often go outside abroad. Everywhere, in immigration, other things. When go, are you a magician? Can you do a magic trick? What I do now, I show.
That's wonderful, that's great. That's how you do it in public. So So we have seen a beautiful magic by our great magician, and we'll see some more and end the program over here. So I think you should spend some more time with the audience, and they must see some more of your performances and magics. So I'm taking a leave right now with the audience, and thank you so much for being with us. Have a good day and bye-bye.
Thank you very much.